And there, that day when the great light of heaven burned at his lowest in the rolling year, on the waste sand by the waste sea they closed. Nor ever yet had Arthur fought a fight like this last dim, weird battle of the West. A death-white mist slept over sand and sea. And friend slew friend, not knowing whom he slew. And one last act of kinghood shalt thou see yet ere I pass. And uttering this, the king made at the man. Then Mordred smote his liege hard on that helm, which many a heathen sword had beaten thin. While Arthur at one blow, striking the last stroke with Excalibur, slew him. And all but slain himself, he fell. Then spake King Arthur to Sir Bedivere, "Though Merlin swear that I should come again to rule once more, but let what will be, be. I am so deeply smitten through the helm that without help I cannot last till morn." But now delay not, take Excalibur, and fling him far into the middle mere. Watch what thou seest, and lightly bring me word. To him replied the bold Sir Bedivere, "Yet I thy hest will all perform at full. Watch what I see, and lightly bring thee word." By zigzag paths and juts of pointed rock came on the shining levels of the lake. There drew he forth the brand Excalibur, but at the last it seemed better to leave Excalibur concealed. So strode he back slow to the wounded king. Then spake King Arthur to Sir Bedivere, "Hast thou performed my mission which I gave? What is it thou hast seen, or what hast heard?" And answer made the bold Sir Bedivere, "I heard the ripple washing in the reeds and the wild water lapping on the crag." To whom replied King Arthur, faint and pale, "Thou hast betrayed thy nature and thy name. Yet now I charge thee, quickly go again as thou art lief and dear, and do the thing I bade thee. Watch and lightly bring me word." Then went Sir Bedivere the second time across the ridge and paced beside the mere, his palms together, and he cried aloud, "And if indeed I cast the brand away, surely a precious thing, one worthy note, should thus be lost forever from the earth, which might have pleased the eyes of many men." And so strode back slow to the wounded king. Then spoke King Arthur, breathing heavily, "What is it thou hast seen, or what hast heard?" And answer made the bold Sir Bedivere, "I heard the water lapping on the crag, and the long ripple washing in the reeds." Then spoke King Arthur, breathing heavily, "Yet For a man may fail in duty twice, and the third time may prosper. Get thee hence. But if thou spare to fling Excalibur, I will arise and slay thee with my hands. Then quickly rose Sir Bedivere, and ran, and leaping down the ridges lightly, plunged among the bulrush beds, and clutched the sword, and strongly wheeled and threw it. The great brand made lightning in the splendor of the moon, and flashing round and round and whirled in an arc, shot like a streamer of the northern morn. So flashed and fell the brand Excalibur, but ere he dipped the surface, rose an arm clothed in white samite mystic, wonderful, and caught him by the hilt and brandished him three times, and drew him under in the mere. And lightly went the other to the king. Then spoke King Arthur, drawing thicker breath, "Now see I by thine eyes that this is done. My end draws nigh. 'Tis time that I were gone. Make broad thy shoulders to receive my weight, and bear me to the margin." So sighed the king, muttering and murmuring at his ear, "Quick, quick, I fear it is too late, and I shall die." Then saw they how there hove a dusky barge, dark as a funeral scarf from stem to stern. Three queens with crowns of gold, and from them rose a cry that shivered to the tingling stars. Then murmured Arthur, "Place me in the barge." So to the barge they came. There those three queens put forth their hands and took the king and wept. Then loudly cried the bold Sir Bedivere, "Ah, my lord Arthur, whither shall I go? If thou shouldst never see my face again, pray for my soul." So said he, and the barge with oar and sail moved from the brink like some full-breasted swan. Long stood Sir Bedivere, revolving many memories, till the hall looked one black dot against the verge of dawn, and on the mere the wailing died away. The strange rhyme of bygone Merlin. Where is he who knows? From the great deep to the great deep he goes.